this demo and presentation is to give a brief overview of the session isolation feature, the reasons for coming up with this feature, ways of configuring the feature, session isolation, a brief demo demonstrating the capabilities of the feature, and then a few sections at the end which will be useful from a technical perspective for diagnosing or for understanding the issue itself, the feature itself. We will briefly follow this agenda, first checking what the behavior was before this feature was introduced and segueing into the impetus for the feature itself. The prerequisites that will be installed for enabling session isolation, a brief description of what use cases are affected, a few notes on how we have designed it, and specific implementation points that would be useful from a technical perspective. A quick demonstration of features that have been affected by session isolation, a brief note on diagnostics, providing links for documentation, and details of the known issues or limitations that we are shipping this feature with. Quite simply put, before session isolation, the current implementation that was used in Marimba for handling the separation of service session from user sessions by Microsoft was flawed to a certain extent. At the time when we were trying to handle that change in the operating system, we did so by configuring the tuner to stop the Java process and restart it whenever a user logged in that user session. While this would ensure that you could see the UI, which was the primary impetus for this feature itself, there were side effects and consequences of this, because now we would have to ensure that we are cleaning up services properly before restarting in the next session. And since this is not always possible, we saw a number of customer issues, for example, corruptions in storage, or UI not displaying properly, or UI disappearing after a while, etc. It is for this purpose that we came up with the session isolation feature. A brief description on what the session isolation feature involves will now follow. We now intend to follow a Microsoft recommended approach, which you can see in various NSDL articles that have been provided. Their suggested approach involves separating UI components from a service application when dealing with session isolation. And to a certain extent, that's exactly what we have done here. The tuner, along with the dependent Java process or the minituner.exe, will now continuously run in session 0. This is almost the same as how when you had session affinity set. Your tuner does not move out of session 0 in response to any user logon or any user logoff or user connects, disconnects. It will continue to work as it is. At the same time, we now have a new component of the tuner process called the marimbaclient.exe. This itself triggers a Java process, which will then encapsulate the entire UI functionality for the Marimba tune. It will also be responsible for interacting with the Marimba tuner when it needs to receive or transmit instructions or events which are related to UI. A benefit of this approach is that there are no longer interruptions to channel operations or other critical tuner services. It makes use of Windows features for ensuring that the Marimba client is always available when a user logs in. So it frees up some of the responsibility from the tuner for that purpose. At the same time, the services in the tuner corresponding to UI to a certain extent can now be specialized for specific use cases, and the responsibility or the burden of generating the actual UI has now been offloaded to the Marimba client process. A brief note on prerequisites and additional information for enabling and obtaining the session isolation feature. In terms of prerequisites, you will obviously need the 8.3 version of Infra Service. Your tuner should be running as a service to make use of the session isolation feature. one thing that we have done is kept the implementation behind a tuner property, which allows you to enable or disable session isolation at will. It is the marimba.tuner.sessionisolation.enabled property. We've had to modify certain channels that ship with endpoint tuners in particular in order to support showing of the UI through the Marimba client process. For that purpose, you will also need to upgrade the inventory service and policy service channels. A quick note here, it is intended to use session isolation only on Windows Vista and above, much the same way as session migration. Your Marimba client launches its own Java process in order to show UI Nighthawk. At the same time, we have taken steps to ensure that the memory footprint is restricted to a specific value. More on this later. And also, the Marimba client process along with the accompanying Java process will run in the user context rather than the system context, which is fine for us because our intention is mostly to show UI using this EXE and not do much of disk IO or network, which would ordinarily require privileged APIs in order to use. Before we jump into the demo, we will just quickly take a look at the use cases which are affected by session isolation. To a certain extent, any kind of operation that involves display of a UI has been affected by session isolation. So this includes packages, the UI which is shown up to give the user the choice to install or defer installation, the scan progress that is shown by inventory service or the permissions dialog box, the tuner icon, tuner messages, tuner prompts, reboot dialogs, no dialogs from CRS UCS. All of these have been modified in order to support session isolation, with certain exceptions. We will get to these exceptions in the known limitations section of this presentation. We will also briefly touch on the architecture and specific implementation details of the session isolation feature. As we mentioned here, given the current model that Microsoft recommends, we will keep the tuner.exe and the Java process components running in session 0, which is the service session. It will continue to function as it does over there, updating starting channels, providing a platform for server type channels like transmitters, proxies, providing ability to administer the machine remotely, trigger installation scripts. All this will continue to happen while the tuner is running in session 0. The only addition that has happened now is the Marimba client.exe, which will actually run in the user session. It will show a specific UI of its own depending on how you have configured the tuner. And any UI dialogs initiated by the tuner will be transmitted as messages to the Marimba client process. So your Marimba client EXE will receive tuner instructions and it will spawn the UI dialogs as required. When a user makes a selection on the UI, whether it is clicking off a button or where it involves ensuring that a user choice is communicated back to the tuner, at that point of time, that choice will be communicated back to the tuner.exe in order that it can further process it. To dive a little bit further into the implementation details, the communication between the tuner and the Marimba client has two paths. One is from the tuner to the Marimba client process and from the Marimba client process to the tuner. So for the former, we support two versions of message passing. One is short message passing, where what happens is that the tuner sends a very short instruction over a named pipe to the Marimba client process. The second type of operation is what we call a long message passing. This is when certain extended information has to be provided to the Marimba client process in order to ensure that it is able to receive all the information required in order to show a proper UI. So one very good example of this is when showing a UCS dialog. In this case, it's not enough just to instruct Marimba client to open the dialog. it is also necessary to provide Marimba client a list of all the packages that have been configured to use UCS before they can be installed. Since this can be a pretty big list with a lot of information, this is best served by wrapping it in a Java object which can be serialized into a memory map file. And the Marimba client will then be monitoring this memory map file for receiving these messages and translate them into UI dialogs accordingly. As you can see, we've ensured that Marimba client can start up on logon using the Windows Run Registry key, and we've also ensured that it uses minimal memory using the hyphen XMX setting for the Marimba client Java process. We can now jump into the demo for this feature. At this point of time, the use cases themselves are extensive, but we can restrict ourselves to specific use cases in which changes have been made. For example, package installation UI dialogs, the reboot prompt that comes from CRS, a new manage button in the context menu that opens the lightweight tune admin console, even UCS packages as well. For the purposes of this demo, I have installed a tuner on a Windows 7 VM that we have in our lab, and using this this machine, we can demonstrate the features for session isolation. As you can see, while this may not look like much of a change compared to the tuner, that is precisely the point. We aim to give as much of a similarity of experience when you have session isolation disabled. Here you can see that using the manage button, we can actually access the lightweight tuner admin console in order to perform operations on the tuner. For example, you can use lightweight tuner admin to use the policy service to bring down a UCS enabled package. Here, as you can see here, it does not look like much of a change in terms of functionality. You will continue to have, in the case of UCS, a tuner icon which is spawned by the Marimba client that shows that there are updates required. And when you click the View Software Updates, you should see that the a dialog pops up which tells you that a UCS package is available, and you can then install this much the same way as you do with UCS. When you do an operation specifically related to single packages, your customer will expect to see the same UI that you had expected when running packages without session isolation enabled or before pre.3 tuners. So for that purpose, we have ensured that you get a similar experience in terms of package dialogs, which we will demonstrate right now. When you click the package UI, you will expect it to work the same way as it would if it was a tuner from a previous version without session isolation enabled. Finally, when installing a package or a patch that requires a reboot, you can see that the CRS feature is able to make use of the Marimba client.exe in order to ensure that you can see some kind of reboot prompt which gives you details of what was the CRS package or the patch that was installed. And you can use that to behave the same way that you would expect the CRS reboot to behave. It will work the same way. One thing to note here, we've already mentioned that when a user logs in, we make use of the Microsoft Registry key, which is a key that we can set with the location of the marimba client.exe. This ensures that when a user logs in, Microsoft Windows itself will take care of ensuring that the tuner exe comes up. Vmahindraclient.exe comes up. So this way frees us from the responsibility of keeping it always on. Unless of course you restart the tuner or quit the tuner and start it again. In which case the tuner has the ability to start up the Mahindraclient.exe again. You can use the about option in the Mahindra context menu to see information about the tuner, much the same way that you would if you were on a pre-8.3 tuner. To give you an idea of how things are working, you can see that the Mahindraclient.exe is in memory along with a very minimal java.exe. This exists separately from the tuner.exe. And you will usually see one per user, the username denoting the context in which Mahindraclient.exe is running. Coming back to our presentation, we will just go through a short description of what diagnostics have to be performed in order to verify that the session isolation feature is working correctly. We have a certain number of log messages that indicate that the tuner has sent an instruction to Marimba client, or that the Marimba client has received some user input and has to give it back to the tuner. So you can see here, for example, the log messages here indicate that someone has clicked the open button in the context menu from within Marimba client, which is usually the signal for the tuner to launch the primary URL channel. In addition, for extended information, we have a debug flag called tuner/marimba client. Unfortunately, it is difficult to see messages related to the Marimba client working itself. We've not had much success in transplanting log messages or error messages from within Marimba client. However, the tuner side messages during interaction with Marimba client can be seen using this debug flag. In addition to log messages, there are always a series of visual checks that you can perform to ensure that the session isolation is working correctly. You should check that the property is configured, marimba.tuner.sessionisolation.enabled. Confirm that the tuner's Java process is running in session 0. As we saw in the demo, the task manager will show you instances of Marimba client and Java. There are certain things that you can do to ensure that the tuner is able to communicate with Marimba client. You can use the Process Explorer tool for this reason. Using this tool, you can actually see whether the marimba client.exe is in a position to receive instructions from the tuner. All this is a little technical stuff, more useful from the side of support or resolution team that wants to debug issues with session isolation. One thing to note here, which may have to be communicated to customers, since the Marimba client exe runs in a user session, it has very limited privileges compared to the tuner. For this purpose, we had to choose what you would call a safe folder in which Marimba client specific data could be dumped and accessed. For this purpose, you will see from now on that the Marimba client will now dump application specific data into the folder pointed to in the all users profile directory. Now on some laptops this will be the C:\program data folder. It might change depending on how individual customers have configured environment variables on their operating systems. Coming to documentation for this feature, we have the latest updated software design document at the location provided. Because we had reduced the scope of the session isolation feature mid-release, the original document had to be updated substantially to take into account all the changes we had done and the authorizations that had been done to ensure that the feature was delivered on time. All of this has been updated in the SDD provider. The UAT document still details all the use cases that were expected to be covered. And we have also, we will be uploading this recorded demo into a specific location so that this can be accessed for further review by product management and for other types of management. Finally, we come to the known limitations of this feature. So in this case, we have removed a lot of the limitations that were present in the beta. However, there were certain limitations that we had accepted would be happening even when we released the product, and we put these out here. So for one thing, not all channels can coexist with session isolation. There are certain channels that you would not normally find on multiple endpoints. You would usually find them on specialized machines that our customers have configured for the purpose. For example, packaging machines requiring app aggregator, channel copier, or the certificate manager, etc. These channels have not been translated to work with session isolation, and it is recommended that you disable session isolation when using these channels. In addition, one sort of gray area, while our customers usually depend on Marimba to provide functionality for UI, whether it is through the package or the CRS or UCS, etc., there are channels out there in the environment written by Field which have their own UI. These channels may not work correctly with session isolation, and this is something that we will be expecting to hear from feedback from customers when they start using the feature. So it is one thing that everyone should be warned of, that these are limitations with session isolation. Session isolation will not work with these features. This concludes the presentation plus demo for the session isolation feature. Thank you all for listening.